Welcome to Expat Town. What's your name?
Matt.
Cardle. You want to make your way into the holding area.
Thanks a lot.
Today, Thank you.
I'm Matt. I'm 27. I'm from Essex.
What do you think?
I'm a painter by, well, at the moment, a bit of a bum, but I'm doing a bit of painting at the moment.
Don't put yourself down.
It's the truth, though, I'll be honest. I've been working as a painter for a couple of years now. At the moment, I'm painting hotel rooms. It's boring and monotonous, and it's horrible. I hate every minute of it, to be honest. I just try and keep myself going by singing. I've been thinking about auditioning for a few years now.
Why was it this year you thought, go on?
I just thought I was ready this year, I think. This opportunity would mean the end of Magnolia all over my face and hands.
On you go.
The end of Brush is the end of hotel rooms. It would be the break I need, so I am desperate to get through.
Hello.
Hello there, how you going?
What's your name?
My name's Matt Cardle.
Okay, and Matt, how old are you?
I'm 27.
And what's your job?
I'm a painter by trade every now and again, but I'm a bit of a bum if I'm honest. It's the truth.
And Matt, why are you here today?
I'm here to do my level best and just see what I can do or what I can't do, you know?
Okay, and what are you going to sing today?
Amy Winehouse, I'm No Good.
Okay.
Meet you downstairs in the bar and high. You're rolled up sleeves in your skull t-shirt. You say, what did you do with him today? And sniffed me out like I was Tanqueray. Cause you're my fellow, my guy. Hand me your Stella and fly. By the time tear me down like
Rodrigo.
I cheated myself like I knew I would. I told you I was trouble. You know that I'm no good.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Because you've got a very unusual voice. It's a great voice, and you're very musical. You're a bit awkward on stage and all that, but there's something quirky and likable about you.
Thank you.
Bless him, he looks so awkward, doesn't he? He's like...
Okay, let's go. Louis, yes or no?
Matt, I'm going to say... yes.
Thank you.
I'm going to say yes.
Thank you so much, Sarah. Thank you.
Matt, I decided after hearing that Amy Winehouse song that I really, really like you.
Thank you so much.
So you're going to get an almighty yes from me as well. Well done.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well done. How'd you feel?
I feel great now. I just need to go and have a cigarette and a beer.
Matt Cardle's got the X Factor.
I live at home in Halstead, Essex with my parents. It's not ideal to be still at home at 27.
How you doing, Matt? Good, man. Good. You ready? Ready?
Today means so much. I'd never really considered it up until now, and the closer you get to it, the more you want it, like anything, like, you know, like when you're doing your driving lessons, you don't mind not driving until you've been in a car and you've driven it around, and then you want your own one, you know? It's a bit like that, but way more important. I've taken a bit of a risk with the song I've chosen. It's a girl's song, and I think I'm the only guy in bootcamp that's doing that song. I think it's right to take a risk at this stage, just to stand out.
It's very tender, beautiful. Yeah. But I need more pronunciation.
Okay. I'm nervous, I'd be lying if I said I wasn't. If I go out there and I don't nail the song, then, you know, then I should have done better.
Hi.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
It's an absolute pleasure and honour to be amongst this lot. There is some genuine stars out there, and hopefully that you may think there's one of them standing. Thank you very much. But like it felt amazing.
He's the biggest surprise of today for me.
Why didn't we notice him before? Can I tell you why?
Yeah.
No confidence or self-belief whatsoever.
People can over rehearse, I think. I've just been trying to keep it ready for that. And I just praying to God that was enough.
Matt Cardle.
That is former painter and decorator and gigging musician, 27-year-old Matt Cardle from Halstead in Essex.
First time.
And for Matt, even getting to Australia was an ordeal in itself.
It's a huge plane, so I mean, I think that might be slightly less bumpy than the little ones, but it's still pretty damn scary, so I'm not looking forward to it either way, but there we go.
In the past, I've worked as a postman, I've worked as a milkman, I did a short spell with a circus. I was a Santa Claus. I was only 18, I had my little Reebok Classic sticking out of the Santa suit. It was ridiculous. My heart wasn't in it for once. It's hugely frustrating because I just want to be singing as a career, as a full-time affair. Doing well today, you know, could mean the end of rubbish jobs, no real direction. I gave up the painting because I couldn't stick it anymore, to be honest, be it on a building site or in a hotel room or whatever. This could really turn my life completely inside out and upside down, which is what I wanted to do.
Hi, Matt.
All right.
How are you?
Yeah, good.
Give it everything, yeah?
If I were a boy, even just for a day,
listen to her.
but you're just a boy.
Thank you. Thank you. I was hating myself for the first half of that because I'm like, did I give him the hardest breaking song to sing? That was really, really tough.
How do you feel?
I feel okay.
I was sat in a hotel room, probably not painting if I'm honest. Just wishing I wasn't there. It's just indescribable how much of a difference it could make. Just that difference in a yes or a no. It's like, it's home time or it's game on. I have been trying for so long and I sing it every weekend, but it is just in sticky floored pubs, and people have said, Matt, you know, you're a dreamer. And said, when are you going to sort yourself out and get a job and that? And I tell him all the time, I'm like, man, just wait, I'm going to do it, I'm going to make it. And let yourself. It's that close now. And I just want to do it for myself and for those, the people that I love. You know?
You've got this unique voice. I love the fact that you go into that falsetto so easily. That's kind of your signature. What concerns me is the connection. Natalie and I were both concerned through the performance. We just kept saying, I want him to look at us. You've got to look at the audience.
Yeah.
They've come to see you. So I've taken all of that into account. I've made my decision.
No!
Yes!
Thank you so much.
Now, can you look me in the eyes?
Thank you so much.
Can you do this?
Mm-hmm.
I cannot believe it. I just can't believe it.
Story night on three!
Matt was so excited that for the first time ever, his hat came off. Albeit briefly.
No!
Yes!
That's right, it's 27-year-old Matt Cardle.
Matt, you're going through.
It's amazing.
It's insane. Absolutely insane.
Yeah, couldn't believe it. What a ride we've had. And we're going to take you back to your very first audition.
Being on stage at that audition was a bit of a blur. It was weird hearing my voice coming out. And, you know, Simon, Cheryl and Louis sat there and, like, 3,000 other people. Now the door, you tear me down
like Roger Moore. I cheated myself. You're going to get an almighty yes from me as well. Well done.
For him to say something like that to me was just like, oh, my God. I couldn't get my head around it.
Since your audition aired, what's the response been like out and about?
It's been weird being recognised, and it's just insane how 5 minutes on the telly can... It just shows how many people watch it. I'm just me, you know what I mean? And even though I'm here and I've got through, I'm still me, and like if people do... Yeah, I don't know.
Surreal.
It's so surreal.
Are you going to keep the hat?
Yeah.
That's your thing,
isn't it? It ain't coming off.
And through the whole X Factor process, Matt has never taken his hat off. Well, except for jet skiing. Oh. Well, except for swimming. Oh. Okay, never mind.
How would you describe what you do? What is it?
Sing like a girl.
That voice, when you can go through into that falsetto, I can give him any song to sing, guys' songs, girls' songs. It really is special. There's not many people who can do that and do it well. And he's so unassuming. He's kind of the anti-pop star.
So what are you looking forward to most with the live show?
Seeing in front of that many people, it's just going to be mind-blowing. So that's one of them.
Wow. Yeah.
And just getting involved in it. And I mean, this is a gift. The whole thing's been a massive gift. But I've got to the point that I was...
Yeah. Well, do you think you can win this thing?
Oh, hell yeah. Give him half a chance.
Yeah?
Hell yeah.
Give him half a chance now. Let's do this thing. Win, yeah?
Please.
Yay! Thank you so